Hello students, welcome to this live session for class 11 students of biology subject. This is the second session for chapter 2. Due to some technical issue, our live session was interrupted. So I am just continuing the same session. We were studying chapter 2 of class 11th biology, biological classification. And so far, I had discussed with you the classification system given by Aristotle and the classification system given by Carolus Linnaeus. And now we were discussing, I was teaching you the five kingdom classification system given by R. H. Whittaker. So R. H. Whittaker, he proposed five kingdoms. He grouped all the living world in five kingdoms. And these five kingdoms were Kingdom Monera, Kingdom Protista, Kingdom Fungi, Kingdom Plantae, and Kingdom Animalia. So these five kingdoms. So in the course of evolution also, now we know that the development of the organisms on Earth, how the organisms appeared on Earth, the sequence was the same. Kingdom Monera, all the organisms of Kingdom Monera appeared first. Then came the organisms of Kingdom Protista, then appeared the organisms of Kingdom Fungi, and then Kingdom Plantae, and finally the most advanced forms of Kingdom Animalia. So it means that Whittaker, he very keenly followed those dimensions which were overlooked by the earlier scientists. Whittaker, he focused his classification on the aspects like the body organization, the cell structure, the mode of nutrition, method of reproduction of organisms, and the most important aspect, phylogenetic relationship. Now, one by one, we'll deal with these aspects. The first aspect being the cell structure. So Whittaker, he grouped the organisms on the basis of the cell structure, whether the cell is prokaryotic or eukaryotic. I have already discussed in first session the difference between a prokaryotic cell and eukaryotic cell. All the membrane bound organelles are found in eukaryotic cells. And those cells which lack membrane-bound organelles are called prokaryotic cells. So in the course of evolution, we can easily judge which type of cells appeared first. Of course, prokaryotes appeared early in the course of evolution and eukaryotes then after. Eukaryotic cells and eukaryotic organisms, they are more advanced. So Whittaker considered this point in classifying the organisms. That is how he made five kingdoms. Now, the next aspect considered by Whittaker was body organization. By body organization, he meant to say whether the body is organized in a single cell, that is, the organism is unicellular, ek hi cell ka bana hua organism hai, or the organism is multicellular, ya phir ek se zyada cells uski body mein present hai. Ye bahut important tha. ये फीचर बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट था जिसके बेस पर टू किंगडम क्लासिफिकेशन नहीं दी गई थी. देन अनदर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एस्पेक्ट वाज मोड ऑफ न्यूट्रिशन. ऑर्गेनिजम्स किस तरह से न्यूट्रिशन लेते हैं, क्या वो अपना खाना खुद बनाते हैं, आर दे ऑटोट्रॉफ्स, ओनली अ फोटोसिंथेटिक ऑर्गेनिज्म हैविंग क्लोरोफिल कंटेंट कैन बी ऑटोट्रॉफ. Or there is a diversity in autotrophic nutrition, like the organism may also be chemoautotroph. Or the organism can be heterotroph. If the organism is not having chlorophyll content, the organism cannot undergo photosynthesis, then such organisms are called heterotrophs. mode of nutrition was also a very important aspect for classifying the organisms in five kingdoms. Next important feature which he followed was method of reproduction. किस तरह से ऑर्गेनिज्म रिप्रोड्यूस करते हैं? Now the basic mode of reproduction, the very basic mode of reproduction was asexual reproduction. So asexual reproduction, and then the advanced organisms they undergo sexual reproduction. So this aspect was also greatly followed by Whitaker in grouping the organisms in five kingdoms. Finally, the most important aspect was phylogenetic relationship. किस तरह से phylogenetic relationship organisms को आपस में relate करती है? For example, what is phylogenetic relationship? This phylogeny, this is a term which you must know before understanding this aspect. What is phylogeny? Phylogeny is study of relationship among different group of organisms and their evolutionary development. किस तरह से अलग अलग organisms आपस में evolution के course में related है? किस तरह से ऑर्गेनिजम्स जो है वो कॉमन एंसेस्ट्री को फॉलो करते हैं? मींस ऐसे ऑर्गेनिजम्स जिनके एंसेस्टर्स कॉमन है, ऐसे ऑर्गेनिजम्स आपस में बहुत ही क्लोजली रिलेटेड होते हैं, उनमें बहुत सारी सिमिलैरिटीज पाई जाती हैं और उनको क्लोजली ग्रुप करना चाहिए, उनको एक ही ग्रुप में डालना चाहिए. तो इस एस्पेक्ट को विटकर ने फॉलो किया, फाइलोजेनी को फॉलो किया. फाइलोजेनी से हम कॉमन एंसेस्ट्री ढूंढ सकते हैं ऑर्गेनिजम्स की. Phylogeny shows the common ancestry, और जो organisms जिनके ancestors common है, इसका मतलब उनका course of evolution भी आपस में linked है और वो common group में group किए जाने चाहिए. और ये बहुत important aspect था जिसने Whitaker की five kingdom classification को इतना successful बनाया. Okay, so now Whitaker he classified the whole living world in five kingdoms: kingdom Monera, kingdom Protista, किंगडम फंजाए, किंगडम प्लांटी एंड किंगडम एनिमलिया. तो सारे ऑर्गेनिजम्स को ये पांच किंगडम्स में डाल दिया गया, जो ऑर्गेनिजम्स तब तक उसने डिस्कवर किए थे, उनकी बात हो रही है. ओके, नाउ कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स, कौन कौन से कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स को फॉलो करके विटकर ने ये पांच किंगडम्स में उनको डाला? सेल टाइप, सेल वॉल, न्यूक्लियर मेम्ब्रेन, बॉडी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन एंड मोड ऑफ न्यूट्रिशन, ये पांच बेसिक कैरेक्टर्स थे. हम इस टेबल को डिटेल में स्टडी करेंगे, डिटेल में हम इसको फॉलो करेंगे नेक्स्ट सेशन में. सो इन द सेशन थर्ड ऑफ द चैप्टर टू विच आई विल बी टेकिंग टुमारो, आई विल डिस्कस दिस टेबल विच इज गिवन इन योर एनसीईआरटी. थैंक यू.